Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.4, Problem 3. This is Section 10.4, Problem number 3. It says, according to a recent article in Spoil Your Pet magazine, 60% of Americans that own a dog let their dog sleep on the bed at night. Victoria, the very virtuous veterinarian, believes that the percentage is even higher than 60%. She conducts a survey of 150 of her clients that own dogs and discovers that 97 of them let their dogs sleep on the bed. Conduct a hypothesis test at a 10% level of significance to test the claim that more than 60% of dog owners let their dogs sleep on the bed. So, this hypothesis test, we want to test that claim. So the first step, there are six steps altogether. The first step is write the null hypothesis. So the symbol is a capital H with a subscript of zero. Most hypothesis tests have the symbol mu in the null and alternate hypothesis, and mu is a symbol for the population mean. Now here we're testing a proportion, so it's P, it's not mu. P for proportion or percentage, if you like. And the null hypothesis will have the condition of equality. So it could be equal to, less than or equal to, or greater than or equal to. In this case, we can use equal to. And the percentage we want to test is 60%. We want to write that as a decimal. So we can either write 0.60 or just 0.6 is okay. Next, the second step is we want to state the alternate hypothesis. So it's capital H with a subscript of 1. It's still going to have the P. It's going to have the same number, 0.6, but a different symbol. It won't be the equal sign this time. It'll have either a less than, a greater than, or a not equal to, depending on what we're testing. So in this case, we want to test the claim that more than 60% of the people let their dogs sleep on the bed with them at night. More than would be a greater than. You want to test the hypothesis that the percentage is actually greater than 60%. Not greater than or equal to, just greater than. Now, the third step is, what type of test is this? Is this a left tail test, right tail test, or two tail test? So what you want to do is look at the symbol in the alternate hypothesis. If it's an inequality symbol, look at the direction it's pointing in, and that will tell you what type of test you have. This greater than symbol points to the right, so this is a right tail test. Now, what that means is our critical region for this test is in the right side or right tail of our graph. Now, the question says use a 10% level of significance for the test. So if we go into the rightmost 10% or 0.10 on our graph, we're in the critical region, which means we would reject the null. And if we fall short of that, say 90% or in terms of what you'd find in your chart, 0.9000, you would fail to reject the null. So let's do the work and see whether we wind up out in the critical region or not quite in the critical region. So the next step we're going to do is calculate the value for z. The formula for z is z equals x, the observed number of successes, minus n times p, n is your sample size, and p is your proportion that you're testing, over the square root of n times p times 1 minus p. So let's fill that in. Z equals, so x, our observed number of percentages, in this observed number of successes, in this problem is 97. Then we have minus n times p, so n, the size of the sample. Now, for this problem, the size of the sample is 150. There were 150 people tested. And that's going to be multiplied times p as a decimal. That 60% is your p. It goes in as a 0.6. Again, it could be written as 0.60. 0.6 seems a little bit easier. And in the denominator, you will have square root of n, size of the sample, which again is 150, times p, 0.6, the percent or proportion that you're testing, times 1 minus p, so 1 minus 0.6. So that's how the formula for z fills in, and I'll do some of that computation. We will have z equals 97 minus, so now in the numerator, 150 times 0.6 comes out to 90. And under the square root, let me just simplify the last parenthesis a little bit. So I would have 150 for n times 0.6 times 1 minus 0.6 is 0.4. And I'll multiply that out. So in the numerator, 97 minus 90 is positive 7. Again, you want to pay attention to the sign, of course. And under the square root, 150 times 0.6 times 0.4 comes out to 36. Again, don't forget the square root. That's kind of a common mistake. So now I can do the square root of 36. That comes out to 6. So 7 over 6. And now we can go ahead and do that division. You'll probably want to use your calculator for that. You want to do the top 7 divided by the bottom 6 equals. And the calculator is going to say 1.16666. The 6's will go to the end of your calculator screen. A lot of calculators might just make the last 6 into a 7. But it'll be 1.1 and then a lot of 6's. So that's our value for z. So the next step, step 5, is look up your result for z in the standard normal chart. And it's attached at the end of the homework. So to look something up in that chart, what you want to do is write it so that it has two places after the decimal. Here we have an infinite number of places after the decimal. So two places out is the first 6 that shows up. Now we want to round that off. The next digit over is big enough to make it a 1.17. So again, the first part of the process to look up something in the chart is to write it so that it has two places after the decimal. In this case, we had too many places, so we rounded it off, and it rounds off to 1.17. Now what we want to do is split that number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. That 7 will come off. So I'll have 1.1 from the left part and 7 when I take off the rightmost digit. Now, next, what you want to do is put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of just 7, it is 0.07. And now you can actually go ahead and look it up. The digits from the left tell you what row of your chart to look in. And the digits from the right with the 0.0 in front of it tells you what column to look in. You see where the row and the column intersect with each other. And in this case, they will intersect at 0.8790. Now, that's our result from the chart. That's step 5. Step 5 says look up z in the chart. We looked it up and we got 0.8790. Step 6, state your conclusion. Do you reject the null or fail to reject the null? Well, the 879, did it go out into the critical region? It did not. We had to go past 0.9000 to get into the critical region. That 0.8790 didn't quite make it. So, if you don't make it out into the critical region, then you fail to reject the null. Which means, if you fail to reject the null, I think the null is more likely to be true. So it's more likely that the real percentage of people who allow their dog to sleep on the bed with them at night is 60%, just like the magazine claimed. So the last step, step 6, would be fail to reject the null hypothesis.